Realme's new Narzo series phones have been around for a while now. They've all been quite impressive. So naturally, the expectations were pretty high for the Narzo 30 series phones. I received the review units last week. I used the 30A for almost 2 days, and I'd like to give you that first 24 to 48 hour experience of using the phone. You know, when you buy a new phone and start using it, you come across certain features that surprise you and some that kind of disappoint you. So that's what this Not an Unboxing series is about. Without any further ado, let's get started. So the first thing that struck me about this phone is its back panel. I appreciate the fact that it's different, and maybe you guys like it, but personally, to me, it looks like they've taken the back panel from two different phones and put them together. You know what? It actually looks like a combination of Pixel 3 and Pixel 5. The dual tone panel from the Pixel 3 and the camera module from the Pixel 5. Anyway, this is just a matter of personal preference. What I do like about it is how it feels in hand. It's really comfortable to hold. The matte finish provides a decent grip. Now, it's worth mentioning that there is a bit of hollow space here. I'm sure you can notice it. But still, the build quality seems quite solid. It doesn't make any creaking sound or anything. It's just fine. It's super solid. The buttons offer really good feedback. They don't wobble one bit. There is a fingerprint scanner at the back, and again, surprisingly, it's really good. It's super fast and accurate. The user interface is also reasonably fast and snappy. Realme UI is a moderately light skin with minimal bloatware and ads. It has just the right amount of features in my opinion, like custom gestures, screen recording, an extensive panel for privacy settings, etc. The only complaint for me is this is based on Android 10, but it is expected to receive Android 11 update, you know, the Realme UI 2.0 based on Android 11. Even the Narzo 10A and 20A are expected to get it, so we can reasonably assume that the 30A will get the Android 12 update as well in the future. And Android 13 if we are lucky, but we are generally not that lucky. Anyway, breaking news, Android phones are slated to get 4 major Android versions from 2021. For more details, watch this video. Of course, there are a few ifs and buts. I've explained them in that video. So yeah, the interface is quite snappy for a budget phone. It's noticeably faster than the Moto E7 Power that I covered recently. Again, link here. Another reason for that is the use of MediaTek's Helio G85 chip. Now, I'm shooting this video before launch, so I don't know the exact price, but if it's priced at 8,500, then the inclusion of the G85 chip is really commendable. It's fairly decent for gaming. Light games like Headball 2 and Basketball Arena have absolutely no issues running. These are online multiplayer games that are quite competitive, and the 30A does a really good job handling them. I also tried Call of Duty, played a couple of death matches. And again, the gameplay was surprisingly quite smooth. The maximum supported setting is medium plus high, that is medium graphics and high frame rate. And barring a couple of frame drops here and there, the gameplay was absolutely fine. Now, this is not necessarily an upgrade over the Snapdragon 665 chip on the Narzo 20A. The 665 chip performs pretty much the same. For certain tasks, the G85 chip is better. For certain other tasks, the 665 chip is better and more optimized. I don't have the Narzo 20A with me, so I was not able to actually compare them side by side. But here's an example. The 665 chip has good support for Google camera, while the G85 chip doesn't. Also, in terms of efficiency, the 665 chip is better, but I don't think it's a big deal because anyway, the battery has been upgraded to 5000 mAh to 6000. Realme has also included an 18 watt fast charger in the box. I think the 20A supported only 10 watt charging, so this is one major upgrade. There's a whole host of power saving modes and settings using which you can theoretically easily get about 2 days battery life. Realme has some very specific claims like these. You can watch YouTube videos for 27 hours at a stretch. Are you ready? Forget 27 hours. Can you watch technology jog videos for 27 minutes at a stretch? Let me know in the comments. Speaking of videos, this is a 720p LCD display. Nothing much to talk about here. It's the same one from the Narzo 20A. It's pretty big at 6.5 inches. The brightness levels are decent for a budget phone. And just like other phones in this segment, the 20A does not have Widevine L1 certification. So it's not possible to stream content in 720p resolution on apps like Netflix and Prime Video. One disappointing thing here is the camera module. Realme has gone for a 13 megapixel sensor here. Although it looks like an upgrade from the 12 megapixel sensor on the 20A, it's actually not. The 20A's main camera had f1.8 aperture, while this one has f2.2. So expect a dip in low light performance. It does come with a night mode to make things a little better, but guys, anyway, these budget phones are not at all meant for low light photography. But what I'm trying to say is there won't be any improvement in daylight photography either. Again, if I had the Narzo 20A, I would be able to compare and be more specific about the differences. But unfortunately, Realme took it back last month. So barring the battery department, Realme has made some very minor changes to the phone. But I guess that's what we've come to now. Brands want to keep launching phones, updating their portfolios frequently. So the formula has to be like this: make minor changes, bring in something very good, just one thing, but remove a couple of other features. Boom, new phone. It hasn't been 6 full months since the Narzo 20A was launched. If Realme skipped the 30A and instead launched it with better upgrades after a few months, that would make more sense in my opinion. For now, all I can say is this is obviously not a good buy if you already have the Narzo 20A. And rightly so. Why would anybody want to upgrade a phone within 6 months? If you don't have the 20A, if your existing phone is something else, if it's in the last stages of life, if you actually need a new phone in this segment, then this seems like a decent deal. Provided the 3GB RAM 32GB storage variant is priced at 8,500 rupees, strictly. The 4GB RAM 64GB storage variant is expected to be priced at 9,500 rupees. Although the leaked pricing suggests 9,000 and 10,000 rupees for the two variants respectively. You can check the description of this video for the exact pricing details. If the 4GB RAM variant costs 10,000 rupees, then I'd suggest waiting for a review or a comparison between the 30A and the Poco M3. The M3 costs 11,000 rupees, but comes with a full HD display, 48 megapixel camera, 6GB RAM, and dual speakers. So those are, you know, some really significant changes, upgrades in my opinion. So those are my thoughts. What about yours? Would you like to see any comparison between the Narzo 30A and any other phone, say the Poco M3? Let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye and take care.